The VFL Grand Final 1974, Richmond versus North Melbourne. Michael Williamson, on behalf of Lou Richards, welcoming you to the 74 Grand Final. Can North take out their first premiership ever? Hart, the captain of Richmond, won the toss, and the Tigers are kicking up to the scoreboard end as Rantel turns them out back in towards the centre, and the mark is taken there by McGee of Richmond. Lou, what an atmosphere.
A fantastic atmosphere as McGee sends the ball now towards Richmond's attacking zone. As the play kicked off the ground, or kicked out by Richardson, and the ball is out of bounds. There'll be a throw in from that forward pocket position about 30 metres around from the Richmond goal. They're kicking up towards the scoreboard end. Oh, that'd be a free kick. No umpires in play on. Ball comes out to Montgomery. Bartlett's there. They're all having a go at the moment. No one can make up their mind. Rantel diving in. And umpire Robinson will bounce the ball about 45 metres out from the Richmond goal.
Umpire Ian Robinson bouncing the ball. North, notoriously slow starters. They won't need to give too much start here against the mighty Tigers, going for their second premiership in a row. Thorpe now puts them further into attack, but coming out there is Bradley Smith, who played such a magnificent game last week, and Smith is marked in defence. Former East Perth player Bradley Smith pushes it out towards the member stand flank. Players fly high, no mark. The ball knocked away there by Hart. In comes Sheedy, and Sheedy has been awarded a free kick. Grab, I think, too high. Sheedy drives the Tigers right into attack, and the ball goes out of bounds in the forward pocket for Richmond on the member stand side. A capacity crowd here, approximately 120,000 people. Goodingham gets in front of Barm on this occasion. Goodingham gets a tap down. Davis comes in, gets a very heavy one there from Cumming. Over towards Sproul of Richmond. Sproul close to the boundary line, is still going. Tackled by Rantel, it goes through for one behind. The first score of the 1974 Grand Final goes to Richmond, one behind.
Well, waiting on the fullback to bring the ball back into play, it's David Dench. Play pretty tense, as you can imagine. The kick in by Dench is out to the outer side. Ooh. Well, they're all getting up. There's a chance now for the ball to be set up towards that full forward position. Punched away again by Dench from Richardson. And again by Grigg out towards the wing. Pushed away again by Richmond up towards their full forward position. The players set themselves. They all missed as they go now for the ball. Picking it up is Feltham over towards Fagan, but Walsh chips in. They're having a go. They can't pick it up too well. They're downing him pretty heavily, North Melbourne. And the free kick will go to Fagan against Bartlett. He won't give it up. Be a 15-minute penalty here, I'd say.
A bit lucky to get away with that, I thought, North Melbourne. Could have been a free kick for Wayne Walsh. The atmosphere, oh, Lou, isn't it? Tense.
Well, it's electrifying as the free kick goes there to Fagan. He boots the ball around towards that wing position on the member side. Oh, it's just about a mark, I'd say. And it's to Royce Hart, the champion, centre-half forward, and the captain of the Richmond football team. Richmond are not too popular with the crowd at the moment. I suppose one in every 90 or in 100 would be going for Richmond. Up it goes towards Goodingham. He goes for a punch, and the ball is out of bounds, about 20 metres around from the Richmond goal. 1 point to the Tigers, to North Melbourne yet to score.
Throw-in takes place. Barm gets in front of Goodingham, taps it down, takes it. Barm crashes his way through the pack, tries a hand pass, picked up by Bradley Smith. Smith all along, hand pass into no man's land. Hart is there. This could be dangerous. Hart swings it around, pops it into the goal square. Up they go. Oh, chance for Bartlett. Richardson come through.
Free kick.
The free kick has been paid, though.
Dench.
To David Dench. Dench. Looking for the ball. A very strong player. Became the youngest captain in league history a couple of years ago when North appointed him at the age of 20. And he was replaced as captain when Barry Davis transferred from Essendon. What a player Dench is. Oh, magnificent kick. Deep to the halfback flank on the outer side of the ground. Could be paid to Rantel of North. It will be. Rantel on that halfback flank on the outer side. Sproul refusing to pick the ball up for him. Kick from Rantel. Goes to the wing position on that outer side. Players moving into position. Knocked away by McGee. But here's a go for Schimmelbusch. Schimmelbusch of North Melbourne right into the forward zone. Up they go. Wade is in there. No mark. Burke comes out with the ball for Richmond. Burke goes to the wing position on the outer side of the ground. Wood is there. But I think it could have been put over on the full. And Keith Gregg, the winner of the Brownlow Medal in 1973 and again this year, takes a resultant kick. Plenty of speed there from Gregg. Oh, look at him get around. Beautifully done. Gregg now into the forward pocket. Players rush out to meet the ball. They all play. And there's a beautiful mark to Baker. Oh, can this fella hold a grab? Baker is about 35 metres out. He's on an angle, but plenty of goal space open to him, kicking to the outer or Richmond end. It's on its way. It's off the side of his boot, however, and the result, one behind. So scores are level. 1 point each, and we're at the five-minute mark in the 1974 Grand Final first quarter.
Waiting for Dick Clay to bring the ball back into play. 1 point apiece. Dick Clay with a long punt kick, and believe you me, it is a long one. Out towards that half back line, punched away by Goodingham. Kicked away by Morris, but they're back into business through Goodingham, and a mark taken down there on that half back line by Kane. Only a young fella, this bloke, but by golly, he's had a great season in the back pocket. Kicks the ball high, out towards the centre of the ground. Grabbed by Feltham, he's grabbed, couldn't get clear. Pushed away by Sheedy, great play. And now it's out towards Richmond's half forward line. Going out was Farron, a little slow, but gets a hand pass over to Rantel, and he sends the ball wide out towards Shimmerbush. Going after is Morris. He beats Shimmerbush. Beautiful play as he back turns that time and gets the ball back towards Orff Hart. Look at Hart fly that time. Full hand pass over to Walsh. And now they're into attack, Richmond, right down towards their full forward position. Going after is Balm and Bradley Smith. Balm goes down. Bradley Smith won't give in. And the ball is out of bounds about 50 metres around from the Richmond goal.
Waiting for the throw-in. Boy, the atmosphere. You can cut it with a knife. Throw-in. Bradley Smith gets in front, taps it down to Davis, or Montgomery rather. Montgomery gets it out towards the halfback flank on the stand side, taken here by Ryan. Ryan's in a bit of trouble, but steadies on. It's a bad kick, bouncing in the arms of Paul Sproul. Sproul deep into the forward zone for the Tigers, but here's Sheedy. Sheedy goes to hand pass, he does so, and it bounces back. Bartlett tried to, it was a good idea of Sheedy's to handball it right under the boot of Bartlett, but the North back smothered him, and it came back the other way and through for one behind. Things are happening so fast. As Dench kicks out once again, out to the halfback flank on the outer side. Rantel was down, leaving Greg free to come in. Greg races away from Sheedy, gets it to the half-forward flank on that outer side. Mark taken by Shimmerbush. He's a dasher, this fella. Shimmerbush gets it down into the forward zone. Up they go, no mark this time. Through comes Kekovic with the ball there. Oh, Kane, could be a free kick. And Kane of Richmond will take it. Right in the back, there's no shadow of doubt about that one. Kane gets it up towards the centre of the MCG. The Richmond runner seemed to be in the way there. No criticism level at him, it came in pretty fast. And there'll be a free kick paid here to Barry Davis of North Melbourne, the skipper of North.
This is Davis with the ball at centre field. A long punt kick up towards the full forward position. They all fly. Punched away by Green. Going after is Morris. He wins the race for the ball. Good play by Morris. Out towards Greig and Woods. They're having a ding-dong battle out there. And the umpire said it's out of bounds. Out of bounds on the centre wing position. 2 points to Richmond. To North Melbourne, 1 point. No goal as yet. But about only 8 minutes of this first quarter. Ball knocked out by Goodingham, but no one there. Bartlett fumbles the ball. Hooks it back eventually. Back towards the wing position still. Ball pushed to the ground. Goodingham grabs it. A hand pass over to Davis. Davis and everything at the moment. Is it up towards full forward? They all pick
it.
Mark.
There's a mark. He's playing it.
To Kekovic. He's got it. Slamming Sam.
Louis, I was watching him as he came in. He seemed to have Buckley's chance. He didn't seem to be all that interested. And did he trick everybody? Because he just threw himself high into the air and has taken it. Two grabs. Kekovic.
Well, there's Slamming Slam about 45 to 50 metres out from goal. Nearly directly in front. It's a good
goal.
Kick.
It's
a goal. A beauty to Slamming Sam. One goal, 1-7 points North. The Richmond 2 points.
Lou, let's have a look at Kekovic's mark again on our video disc. There he goes. Look at him. At sheer strength. Got him that. Ball about to be bounced once again in the centre. That's an extra added attraction on the Channel 7 network, the use of the video disc. Bounce of the ball by Ian Robinson. Players move in there. Out it comes towards Bartlett. Cleverly pushes the ball in front of him. He's forced to the wing position almost on the stand side. Gets it up towards the forward pocket. Up went Hart. Couldn't come down with the ball. Cumming comes out now. Darrell Cumming from the pocket. Drives in forward. Here's a go for the Tigers. Barry Richardson fell into that one. I say he fell into it. Two players in front of him, one from Richmond, one from North, flew for it. He stood his ground and took the mark. I think he kicked five in the second semi-final against North. Barry Richardson made a remarkable comeback to football late this year after being out for almost two seasons. He's on an angle, as you can see. Need to be a very straight kick. Oh, he's missed it. He's missed it. And nobody's more annoyed or disgusted than Barry Richardson. So that takes Richmond on to three behind straight. North 1-1. North in front, as you can see.
Michael, I think you could say that it's a very pro-North Melbourne crowd at the moment.
It's
unbelievable. You think they were the public enemies number one, Richmond, as the ball goes. Beautiful mark. Too hard. What a champion this fellow is. Every week he plays, he's a very suspect player with injury, but still plays a great captain's game. Up it goes. A chance for Smith to mark. They can't hold the ball. There's a go now. As Pagan picks it up and puts it out. And a penalty free kick will go to Richmond down there in the forward pocket. There's the chance to go a bit closer. Goes for a short pass. It's a good one. Oh, Walsh nearly copped one that time from Feltham, but he missed. Umpire having a talk to him. But he's well within kicking distance, about 45 metres out from
he's
goal.
He's given him a 15-metre penalty.
Listen to that crowd going to town. I think the only ones barring for Richmond at the moment are the players' relations. There he goes, Walsh. Oh, it's a bad kick. Picked up now by... it's a bad one by Dench. This allows Walsh to try and pick it up, but he's forced the ball out of bounds. The umpire's paid a free kick for a push in the back. Well, listen to that crowd going to town. Walsh again to make amends if he possibly can. That's a better kick, and it's a goal. So it's 1-3, 10 points, Richmond. For North Melbourne, 1-1, 7 points. About 11 and a half minutes gone of this first quarter.
And so the Tigers fight back. They'll fight back all day, believe me. They want this second successive premiership. Tommy Hafey, very toey before the game. A dedicated coach. So too, of course, is Ron Barassi. Umpire Ian Robinson gave a very courageous decision then. Hello, some galah in the crowd has pinched the ball. Goodness me, I don't know. New ball being brought out, as you can see. And the police looking into the crowd there to see if they can find the culprit. Well, amongst 120,000 people, I don't envy them the job. But really and truly, people who do that sort of thing should stay home. Go and play croquet or something like that. Not that I'm crook on people who play croquet, so I'll retract that remark. Robinson bounces the ball in the centre. Up they go. Ryan gets a tap away here. Taken by Kekovic, a left footer. Down towards centre half forward for North Melbourne. Look at this. Baker being jostled around there. And McGee takes the mark. 6-1, half a dozen of the other in that duel. McGee coming out on top. Robbie McGee, former Footscray player. Up towards centre half forward for the Tigers. Nobody takes a mark, but in comes Sproul. Sproul steadies. A long one in towards goals. This is going to be close. But it's offline and 1 point results. So the pressure being kept right on by Richmond. North yet to fully hit their straps, Lou, I feel.
Backline a little bit shaky at the moment, Mike. Hasn't settled down as the ball comes back into play this time again by Dench. Out towards Greig. He gets a punch out the wall. Beautifully picked up by Rantel. Rantel drives the ball wide towards Shimmerbush. He breaks clear up towards the forward pocket. There's a go now for Davis, but we see Andrews too strong. And Andrews takes a mark in the back pocket for Richmond. Played very well the last time these two sides met. Just about the best player on the ground as Andrews boots the ball. Right around, Kekovic gets up high. Picked up by Cable. Oh, he's in trouble. He's grabbed. Umpire says play on. Cable still battling and holding the ball against him. Well, he had plenty of chance. Now the free kick going to Wood. Wood's on the wing position. Richmond kicking up towards the scoreboard goal. There's a chance now for Montgomery. Overruns the ball. Cummings got it. He's in trouble. A hand pass. Over towards Cloak. A snap for goal. It looks good. Yes, a goal. It's coming at the 14-minute mark. Their second goal. 2-16 points, Richmond. The North Melbourne, 1-17 points. And the North has can't afford to let the Tigers break clear in this quarter.
No fear they can't, Lou. You can't stand a side like Richmond any start at all, as they found out in the second semi-final. Les Cloak, number 33, a brilliant young player, a great career in front of him, only a baby. Robinson bouncing in the centre once again. There they go, the ruckman move in. Up goes Ryan, taps it out towards Kekovic. Sheer strength got him out of that one. Kicks it out towards the wing position on the member stand side. Not quite here towards Sproul. He's burning Sproul so far. He kicks it in towards the forward pocket on the stand side. Bradley Smith is under it all. Around the neck to Smith, I'd say. But it's called play on by the umpire. The North crowd not very happy about that. Sproul tries to hook it around. It's over the line. And there'll be a throw-in midway between the forward pocket and half-forward flank for Richmond on the stand side. Kekovic having a run on the ball as Goodingham knocks the ball away, and the free kick is going to Barry Goodingham, another former captain of North. They had quite a few captains for a succession there. Oh, he kicks into the man of the mark. Oh, the cardinal sin in football. North backs under pressure once again as the ball is taken there by Sproul. A hand pass, could be a free kick going to Farrant of North Melbourne. Oh, it's the other way. Oh, Louis, what do you reckon?
Well, it looked as though he was grabbed, but the umpire really dropped the ball, so it's against him.
Oh, and Hart to take it. You don't see Hart miss this sort of shot. Oh, but you did on that occasion. One behind. That's a freak of nature. Richmond now go to 2-5-17 to North Melbourne, 1-1-7. 10 points of difference. And we're about midway into the first quarter of the 74 grand final.
Well, there's Dench bringing the ball back into play again. Out to that half back line. Oh, Sam Kekovic got up too early. Pushed away by Greg. But there's Hart. He's all over the place. Playing a great captain's game as the ball goes back. A chance for Ram Talamar. Couldn't hold it. He's grabbed. Pulled to the ground pretty heavily by Richardson. But it's out of bounds. This time it's about 70 metres around from the Richmond goal. Ball back into play. Knocked out by Goodingham. Picked up now by Farron. Over to Burns. Burns goes for a pass. Shimabu's got a chance. He can't get clear. They're all up too many Tigers around as Barb gets it out. To Andrews. He loses it. Through Ryan's legs. Kicked off the ground by Burke. Back to centre field. Walsh punches it away. In goes Walsh again. He's got it clear. Up towards the full forward position. Richardson goes down. In goes Rantel. He can't pick it up. There's a go for Richardson again. They're all piling on top as Farron gets it out. And the umpire will ball it up about 40 metres out from the Richmond goal.
It's hot and tough down there, I can tell you. Rather a trifle humid in Melbourne, if anything. And the play's certainly hot. You're watching it on Channel 7. Robinson. Bounces. The big men move in. Michael Green goes with Goodingham on this occasion. Goodingham gets a tap away and the free kick as well. And so another attack will be turned out. North backs under a lot of pressure early in this game. Out towards Keith Gregg, having a great duel with Wood. Gregg pushing the ball in front of him, gets one in the back, and he's getting the free kick, all right. Now it's a throw-in. Well, listen to the North crowd. They reckon they're getting a raw deal so far. Be that as it may, play goes on. Goodingham taps it away. Shark by Thorpe of Richmond. Intercepted here by Kekovic. And it came through like an international, as you saw. Taken there by Cable. Cable, a long kick into the forward zone. Baker completely surrounded. And Andrews takes another strong mark. He took about 700 marks in the previous match these teams met. Kick now from Andrews. It's a beautiful kick. Up towards centre half forward. Cleverly knocked away by Royce Hart. Rantel of North is onto it. Rantel kicks to the wing position on the outer side, and Wood pulls in a beautiful mark, plays on immediately. Wood puts his boot into it, down to over centre half four there for Richmond. Plenty of North defenders, taken by Feltham, knocked away from Feltham, picked up by Farrant. Look at the pressure he's under. He gets the ball across here towards Pagan. Pagan tries one to the half-back flank on the member stand side. Up goes Ryan, comes out with the ball, a long hand pass by Ryan, over towards Burns. He couldn't get the run of it, he's in trouble, he got a trip. He got a trip and it's been paid. So Burns is on the wing position on the stand side. Burns about to put North Melbourne into attack. A low trajectory drop kick. Up goes McGee. Couldn't get the run of the ball. In comes Andrews. Tries a hand pass. Plenty of Richmond defenders there. Boy, they're really going in hard as the ball is kicked back to the wing position on the stand side. Taken by Francis Burke. Look at this fella go. Oh, but it's... grabbed there by Burns of North Melbourne. Burns deep into the forward zone. Wade is there, gets a front position. It's knocked away from him. Taken by Barm. Barm again drives North Melbourne out. And waiting there is Goodingham on the wing position on the stand side.
But it's Goodingham setting the ball up towards full forward again. The pack fly. Kekovic couldn't take that mark. There's the go now. A shot for goal by Baker, but it'll go through for 1 point. Forward line not settling down. Well, you've got to give credit to the Richmond defence that's playing strong football.
Not giving them a chance to settle down,
no,
are they?
No, they're going in pretty hard. They're all swarming on top of the ball and crowding play like nobody's business. And this makes it hard. Here's Dick Clay bringing the ball back into play. A good punt kick, a chance for Goodingham and Barm. Good play by Barm. Beautiful play. Knocked away from Walsh that time. There's the goal. Could be a free kick. Now he said play on. Not giving up. Francis Burke coming in. Takes the ball away. Went up towards the half forward line. The back fly. Richardson couldn't hold it. Picked up by Bradley Smith. A short pass. Over towards Peterson on the wing. Peterson with another punt kick back. But Francis Burke's there. Or is it the mark taken by Sproul? Sproul with a quick hand pass. And Barm. Up towards full forward goes the ball with a hefty kick. And a mark. Good mark by Bradley Smith. And he's held them out for a couple of seconds at least. Out towards Rantel, right across the face of goals. It's done a leg break in that time and good for the fence and out of bounds about 65 metres around from the Richmond goal. There's 17 points to North Melbourne, 18 points, about 21 minutes gone of this first quarter.
Up goes Green, taps it down. Davis tried to take it. Green picks it up, drives back into the forward zone there for Richmond, and Rantel marks in defence. Johnny Rantel, former captain of South Melbourne. Takes his kick to the halfback flank on the outer side of the ground. No mark taken by Hart. Hart is tackled by Farrant. Gets a kick under pressure. Picked up by Davis of North Melbourne. There's a North Melbourne player down over there. And the ball is on North Melbourne's half forward flank. He's in trouble too, that player. In comes Morris there. But ball pushed over towards Schimmelbusch. He gets it over towards Burns. Burns a beautiful pass to Wade. And Wade plays on immediately. Wade lines him up. He kicks. It's across the face of goals. And bounces over the boundary line. Who is it, Lou, in trouble?
Got a finding for you.
Peterson. Waiting for the throw-in now in the forward pocket for North Melbourne. Throw-in takes place. Kekovic there. Barm gets over the top of him. Through comes Baker. But in comes Dick Clay to relieve the pressure. Clay drives to the half-back flank on the member stand side. Ryan is there. Walsh goes up with him. Waiting behind there was Feltham. He just couldn't get away with it, but he's still in there trying. He's still going, Feltham. What's he going to do with it? He's held. Ryan knocks the ball clear. Free kick has been given here. I reckon it's going to Feltham.
No, I think it's going to Ryan. He was grabbed. The free kick to Ryan. He doesn't even know it. He's got the free kick on the half forward line. There's Peterson, looks a bit groggy. Oh, a kick, a pass. What sort of a pass? It's a bad one. Pushed away now. There's backing up well by Clay. Clay drops the ball a bit short. Sheedy can't hold him up.
In the back.
He's ridden to the ground. And a free kick will go against Rantel that time. Sheedy well out of position. Playing down there on half forward line on Rantel. Is on actually up towards the half back line. A quick hand pass. And a pretty casual one too. As he gets it over to Cumming. Over to Sproul. There's the long kick for goal. Have a look at this one. By golly, what a kick. But it veered off at the last moment and through for 1 point. Tigers playing the stronger football at the moment. 2 goals, 6, 18 points. For North Melbourne, 1 goal, 2, 8 points.
And Sproul has kicked 3 behind straight. 10 points of difference as Dench kicks out. Favours the outer side. It's a beautiful kick too. Deep to the halfback flank on the outer side. Morris knocks the ball clear. In comes Hart. Farrant is after him. Hart in a bit of trouble. Loses possession. Regains it. And a hand pass by Hart. Taken there by Pagan. Pagan in a heck of a lot of trouble. Eventually kicks out towards that halfback flank. Who's going to come out with it? David Thorpe. Back into the attack for Richmond. Bartlett comes in there. Met by Peterson. And Bartlett's down. He's getting it free.
Well, I reckon it was a fair bump. Do you know that? I thought it was a fair bump, Mike.
Well, the North Melbourne crowd already not very happy with umpire Robinson.
That?
Well, his objective was the ball, Lou. There was no doubt about that. He had eyes for nothing else but the ball. Wait for Bartlett now to take his kick within kicking distance. So it's 11 points of difference in favour of Richmond. Dench about to kick out once again. Favours the outer side. It's another beautiful kick. Deep to the halfback flank. Oh, Burns went up before acceptances. Standing behind was Morris, who's taken the mark. Richmond back into attack. Are they keeping the pressure up? It's a beautiful kick from Morris. Right to the edge of the goal square. Hands go up everywhere. Richardson, is it? It is. Barry Richardson, a hell of a good mark. Taken under pressure. Now he is only 12 metres away on an angle, as you can see. Waiting for him to take his kick. Crowd warming up to it. Listen to the crowd as he comes in. It's a goal. They're into time on in the first quarter. 25 and a half minutes gone. And Richmond looking good on the scoreboard. 3-7, 25. North 1-2, 8.
Well, there's 17 points the difference, and a goal would be mighty handy here at the moment for North. Richmond are kicking the scoring end, if any. But a goal just to build up that confidence again. Their back line has been under plenty of pressure, and so has the North Melbourne forward line. What's happened here now? There's a go going on here.
Oh, back at Sears.
Take a look at this. A few of them having a go. Sam Kekovic and McGee. Goal umpire.
Go on, you've said your word. Let them get on with the game, goal umpire.
Well, it certainly livened things up. It might start to spur. Look at the umpire talking to Kekovic.
Well, he seemed to get the blame for everything. Well, we didn't see the start of it.
McGee, in fairness to the umpire.
There's a fair chance Francis Burke won't take a backward step, so it's going to be pretty interesting from here on in.
There's another go here now. Morris has had it. Morris, look at this.
Now, there was a dead set go of Kekovic then. Oh, you've got the wrong fella. You've got the wrong bloke.
Well, they picked the wrong man there, didn't they? Because Morris did go across and try to aggravate him. We'll go back to the centre now. Umpire Robinson throws the ball down. Slightly confused. Knocked out by Green. They can't get clear. Neither side. There's a go. Now, as a free kick, I'd say. A free kick to Cable. He doesn't waste any time.
Oh, look back in the centre.
Look at back in the
back
centre.
Back in the centre.
He's blaming Sam again.
He's talking to Sheedy now. Good stuff. They're watching it on Channel 7.
Well, I think this is what the Northerns are trying to do. They'll try to antagonise them. They're going to do something desperate to stop the Tigers from scoring in this first quarter.
Have a look. It looks like the charge of the Light Brigade. Robertson bouncing the ball on the half-forward flank for North on the stand side. In they go. Up goes Ryan. Gets a big tap away. McGee comes in there. He's got the ball. He's about to be tackled. Over the line it goes. And McGee and Feltham almost put one on there. Up goes Green on his own, gets a tap away, back over the line. It's on the half forward flank for North Melbourne on the stand side. North kicking to the outer or Richmond end. And they come, Ryan once again, he's got one in the back and he's getting a free kick. And listen to the huge crowd, they're all for North, but Richmond have got it on the board at this stage. Deep into the forward zone once again. Oh, Wade was submerged. Out they come. Kane is in there. In goes Baker. Kane comes out with the ball. No, he doesn't. Oh, look, you can see what happened to Kane. Well, he's getting the ball all right. I had doubts for a moment. So Kane of Richmond takes his kick. Swings it slightly to the outer side of the ground, away from the trouble area. In comes Cloak, but it's Montgomery there. Montgomery put under pressure. Kicks down towards the forward on the forward pocket on the outer side. They all overrun it. That's Kane getting his kick back to the wing position. Greg couldn't get hold of the ball. Taken there by Wood. Wood a hand pass over to Walsh. Walsh in Richmond gets his kick. Over centre half forward. The big men fly. It's knocked away here. Look at Richmond go as Hart comes in. Tackled by Farrant. Hart is still going. He'll line it up and do something with it. He kicks. Bradley Smith gets his hands to the ball, but wasn't able to hold it. Threw for another behind. Hart looking a bit annoyed with himself, Lou. He's had two shots that could have been goals, and he's kicked behinds on both occasions.
Well, they've kicked 3-8, which is not their style of football. That's 11 shots to 3, and the ball is out towards the half. Oh, look at Hart getting up very high. Here's a go now for Thorpe. A nice pick up his grab. Just about holding the ball, I'd say.
Oh, blimey.
By golly, I tell you what, they're getting a bit of a rough deal now. North, the ball falls short. And go now for Morris. He goes after the ball like a real tiger, and the ball is out of bounds. Out of bounds. What a few confusing free kicks. Ball back into play again. Green and Ryan. Neither one gets the knock. Ryan finally has another go. He's got it. Threw it out. The cable. Out towards Feltham. He picks it up nicely. Up towards the half forward line. Going after the ball is McGee. And kicks it off the ground. It'll be a penalty free kick. Kicked it off the ground. Out of bounds on the full. Free kick going out there to... Who's it going?
Baker.
Baker to take the free kick. A good 80 metres around from the goal. Up it goes to the forward pocket. As a go for Wade. He can't hold it. It's been about five of them. Kekovic and Peterson. Peterson hooks it back towards the goals. Can Goodingham mark it? No, he can't. Picked up by Wade. He's put through. And that's his 100th goal.
The siren's gone, I think.
He's kicked his 100th goal on the siren.
Or has it? I'm not sure, Lou. No, apparently it hasn't gone.
No, the police were all around the ground to stop the spectators from running off.
Well, that's 100 goals. Beauty, Doug Wade. And North certainly needed it. And look, 120,000 people paying tribute to a great champion. In his career, he's kicked 1,010 goals. But play goes on here at the MCG. Free kick looks like going to North Melbourne. Yes, indeed, it's going to Ryan, back in the centre. The thrill of Wade's 100th goal has passed as Ryan puts his boot into it, drives right down into the forward zone. Look, there's a great mob. Barry Davis takes it for North. His kick is smothered. Francis Burke comes out with it for Richmond. Kicks to the halfback flank on the stand side. A chance for Schimmelbusch. Good hand pass over towards Montgomery. Montgomery under pressure, kicks forward. McGee dives at it. Burke picks it up. Burke gets it back to the halfback flank on the stand side. Schimmelbusch comes in there, gets around Morris, but takes it over the line, and there'll be a throw-in. A throw-in on the half-forward flank again for North Melbourne. Up they go. Ryan's in there. The tap away comes towards Cable. Cable from the pocket, kicks in towards the goals. The ball is still in play. No, over the line it goes, and there'll be a throw-in in the forward pocket on the outer side for North Melbourne. Quarter time about to come up any moment. Goodingham gets in front of Green, but Green gets the tap away. Cable's in there.
Free kick.
Cable gets one high, and he's getting the free kick. Oh, a goal here would be of tremendous importance to North. Cable, there's a siren. Cable about to kick. A left footer, the result, it's a goal! So at quarter time, the scoreboard of the MCG in the 1974 Grand Final reads Richmond 3-8, 26, North Melbourne 3-2.